There are strange things done in the midnight sun by the men who mile for gold. The Arctic trails have their secret tales that would make your blood run cold. In the northern lights have seen queer sights, but the queerest they ever did see was that night on the barge on Lake Lamarche when I cremated Samuel McGee. Now Sam McGee was from Tennessee, where the cotton blooms and blows. Why he left his home in the south to roam around the pole, God only knows. He was always cold, but the land of gold seemed to hold him like a spell. Though he'd often say in his homely way he would rather live in hell. It was Christmas Day, we were mushing our way over the Dawson Trail. True Parker's fold, we talked of the cold, how it stabbed like a driven nail. And if our eyelids closed, then the lashes froze, till sometimes we could not see. It wasn't much fun, but the only one to whimper was Samuel McGee. And that very night, as we lay packed tight in our robes beneath the snow, the dogs were fed and the stars on my head were dancing heel to toe. Sam turned to me and Max said he, I'll cash in this trip, I guess. And if I do, I'm begging you to grant me my last request. Well, he seemed so low, I couldn't say no. Then he said in a whining tone, it's the curse of cold, it's got right hold, and I'm chilled through to the bone. It's not being dead that's my awful dread, it's the icy grave that pains. So I want you to swear, by foul or by fair, that you'll cremate my last remains. Now a pal's last need is something to heed, so I swore I would not fail. And we started on at the streak of dawn, but God, he was ghastly pale. He crouched on the sleigh and he raved all day of his home back in Tennessee. And before nightfall, a corpse was all that was left of Samuel McGee. There wasn't a breath in that land of death, so I hurried on horror driven, with a corpse half hid that I couldn't get rid, because of the promise I'd given. It was lashed to the sleigh and it seemed to say, you may tax your brawn and your brains, what you promised true. Now it's up to you to cremate these last remains. Now a promise made is a debt unpaid, and the trail has its own stern code. In the days to come, though my lips were dumb, in my heart I curse that load. All through the long night, by the lone firelight, while the huskies huddled in the rain, howling out to the crows and the lonely snows, oh God, how I loathe that thing. And every day, the quiet clay seemed heavy and heavier to grow. But on I went till the dogs were spent and the grub was getting very low. The trail was bad, it was driving me mad, but I swore I would not give in. So I began to sing to that hateful thing, and it hearkened back with a grin. Then I came to the barge on Lake Lamarge, and derelict there it lay. It was jammed in the ice, and I saw in a trice it was called the Alice May. Well, I looked at it and I thought for a bit. Then I looked at my frozen chum. Well, here, said I, with a sudden cry, is my crematorium. Some planks I tore from the cabin floor, and I lit the boiler fire. Some coal I found that was lying around, and I heaped it higher and higher. The flames they soared, the furnace roared, such a blaze I never did see. So I burrowed a hole in the glowing coal, and I stuffed in Samuel McGee. Then I made a hike, for I did not like to hear my friends sizzle so. The heavens scowled, the huskies howled, and the wind began to blow. It was icy cold, but the sweat it rolled down my cheeks, I know not why. And the greasy smoke, like an achy cloak, went streaking down the sky. Now I do not know how long in the snow I wrestled with the grisly fear, but the stars came out and they danced about, so I slowly ventured near. I was sick with dread, but I bravely said, I must take a peek inside. He must be cooked, it's time I looked, so the door I opened wide. There sat Sam, looking cool and calm, in the heart of the furnace roar. And he wore a smile you could see for a mile, and he said, please close that door. I'm fine in here, but I gravely fear you let in the cold and the storm. Since I left Plum Tree, down in Tennessee. It's the first time I've ever been warm.